Let's talk masking versus overshadowing. These are two terms that fall under the umbrella of stimulus control with a side of stimulus salience. Now, I've noticed that my students have a hard time discriminating between these two concepts. So let's see if I can make that discrimination a little bit easier. With masking, what's important to note is that there is a skill that is already in the client's repertoire. However, some other competing contingency is preventing the client from correctly responding in the presence of that relevant SD. Like when the phone rings, we know how to answer it, but if you're giving the baby a bath, you're not gonna leave the baby alone in the tub to answer the phone. Or imagine a child being asked to a question in class. They know the answer, but maybe looking cool is more important than providing the correct response. The competing contingencies are the baby's safety and looking cool. Now, overshadowing is something that can happen during skill acquisition. It refers to all the distractions that overshadow the client's ability to acquire a particular skill. Imagine you're working on a tabletop program, but there's a lot of stuff on the table that's grabbing the client's attention and distracting them from the learning program. These distractions, they could be stuff, they could be siblings, TV's on in the background, and what they do is they make the relevant content less salient, and therefore preventing the client from tuning in and focusing in on what they're supposed to be learning. And stimulus control is less likely to be acquired. So the key takeaways: masking, the skill is already in the client's repertoire, but something else is more salient, and therefore stimulus control is compromised, meaning they don't emit the correct response, even though they have it in their repertoire. Overshadowing, the client is in the acquisition phase. The skill is not yet acquired, and there are distractors that are more salient than the learning content, and therefore stimulus control is not able to be acquired, meaning they cannot learn the correct response. And now that you can correctly discriminate between these terms, we have stimulus control. I hope that helps.